In this video, we want to cover the 1-2-3 tool within Track and Trade. This video is a quick reference guide on how to place and the setup of this tool, and not meant to be an educational video on the merits of this tool itself. I also want to make a note here that this feature is exactly the same whether we're using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. You'll notice that I'm using the futures version for this demonstration. The 1-2-3, or ABC tool as we call it, is a multifaceted tool with several different purposes that I'll be highlighting here in this video. You'll notice that I have it selected here in the button bar, and it's the 1-2-3 tool. You'll also notice that the preferences tab is selected, and the preferences for the 1-2-3 tool are displayed. Now the 1-2-3 tool is simply placed on the screen by left clicking, dragging to the from one low point in the trend, left clicking to the second or the high point in the trend, and then the first retracement or the lowest point of the first retracement in the trend. Once I make the third left click, the tool is complete. We have our 1-2-3 formation, and this is indicating a bottoming formation. If we come back and we bring up the 1-2-3 or ABC tool preferences, you'll notice that the preferences have a number of similar types of features as the other tools that we've been covering. The first one is the text. We can come in here and we can adjust the text, and the text can be a number of different things. We can come in, make it 1-2-3, we can make it ABC, ABC caps, ABC with parentheses, whatever you would like to have. I like to kind of make it a little bit larger font so we can see it, make it bold, and you'll notice that the text can either be turned on or turned off. We have the arcs that can be turned on or turned off. The snap to, of course, is what snaps it to the price bar highs and lows, and we can turn that on and off. We also have the ability to always show the lines or turn the lines off. If we say always show the lines and we have that turned off, once the tool is not selected, you'll notice that the lines go away. If we select it again, we bring back up the preferences, always show the lines. Show change calculation. We can also show the calculations in here. We can show this as a dollar calculator style. It shows the amount of money that we're showing. This is $10,839 on this particular chart with a pullback or a retracement of $5,563. We can put that as a return on margin, or we can put that as ticks. And then we can come down here and we can change the quantity, obviously. If we have that turned on in the value, we can change the value quantity, bring that up. Maybe there's a quantity 5 or quantity 6. And you see the numbers change in reference to that quantity. We can also change the text color. Now the next feature that I want to drop into is the extended features based on Fibonacci. And these are our Fibonacci extensions. And I'm going to show those to you now. The first thing you'll notice is that we have our ABC retracement. We're going to turn on our 1-2 or ABC controls. When we turn those on, you'll notice that between A and B, we have additional measuring tools. In this case, the default is Fibonacci, and these are our Fibonacci numbers. Or we can change those to be user definable. For example, you can just put in 50, and you're going to see a marker for 50%. The label here is percent, price, or none, or both, and we're going to just leave that at percent. We can reverse that. Of course, we would have to have something that was 25, let's see, and then if we reverse it, we're going to go to the other side of the marker, and we're going to reverse that to the other side of the price bar. So come in here, put it back to percent, turn off the reverse, go back to 50, and we have our marker set at 50%. Now if we're going to come in here and the next leg is the 2-3 or the BC point between B and C, we can turn that leg on, and then we can see the calculations in there as well. We can have the 1-2-3 retracement level, which is showing this is a 51.3% retracement against that last move between A and B. We can have the Fibonacci numbers, which calculate the Fibonacci down through that series between B and C. Or again, we can go user definable and we can just specify a user definable point. We're going to leave this one here on 1-2-3 ABC. The next point that I want to talk about is the 3-4 or CD. Now this is the projection, the anticipated rise in price, and we turn that one on, and it's going to project out into the future where we anticipate prices rising to. And you'll notice that we can have that set to Fibonacci, which again is going to identify the Fibonacci numbers. And since we have the calculator turned on, the show change calculations, it's showing you the calculations again based on the quantity. If we change that back to 1, we're going to see the calculations based at those different levels of the projection or the amount of money we would anticipate making if we got into the market at the C point and exited at these individual Fibonacci extension points. And so you can see those are labeled by Fibonacci. Again, you can use the user definable, and we can come in here and we can say maybe 25, and we can separate these by commas if we want to have more than one. So we can go comma, maybe 75, 50, comma, 75, comma, 100. So you can set in your own numbers if you would like, separated by commas, and those are going to give you those projection levels. And again, you can have the percent, the price, or both, or you can have them labeled as none, and then you can come in and you can reverse them by putting them on the other side. And then we have the projections. Again, this is beyond 100, so you have one more that goes out beyond 100, so we can go projections beyond 100. And again, we can use Fibonacci, and you can see that it's automatically put the Fibonacci numbers in there for you based on that level. Or again, you can do user definable. You can do 125, comma 150, comma 175, comma 200, and that would have your own user definable fields. This one will just stick with Fibonacci, and you'll notice again that because we have the calculations turned on, those numbers are showing out there as well. And that is a simple use of and setup of the 123 tool in Track and Trade.